don't speak much, so when he do, you gotta listen to him.
Right.
There you go.
We were all like this.
All right, gang, go ahead.
I think he had a great game. He came in, he did what he's supposed to do. I don't think he had any busts. I mean, I don't think he had a catch caught on him. So, a ball caught on him. So, I think he came in and filled the shoes very well. He's always got a good head on his shoulders. He's never negative. He's never down just because he's not getting the playing time. He comes in, he works hard. He's very consistent, has great ball skills. I think he's technique-wise, he's been working on some things. I've been working with him on a couple of things. So, like pressing and stuff like that. So, everybody can improve in those areas and everybody got something to work on. But I think he's been quiet on the low, just working, keeping his head down and low maintenance. He's a low maintenance guy, so I think he's been really consistent with that.
Elijah, what was your view of the Javon Ritzy pick?
I was like on the in the end zone, and I kind of seen it happen, and I was like, "What? Like, he just caught the ball," and I thought he was gonna get tackled, and then he kept running. I was like, "No, he did not just pick six." He's like, "I don't even have a pick six," so I was a little bit jealous. No, I wasn't jealous, but I was excited for him. That's big. That's a big time play. Yeah, I did. It was a whole bunch of stuff going on the sideline when that happened. It was hilarious. Yeah, the stiff arm. Yeah, that was a huge play.
We had that in him. Like, have you ever seen him run for that long of a distance at one time?
Oh yeah, Javar is a crazy athlete. He's a freak athlete. I've seen him do some crazy things. I'd be like, whoa, like how are you that big? You can jump higher than me, jump farther than me. He's an athlete. He's very athletic. I kind of liked Florida growing up. Like my mom, she's a big Gator fan. One of my teammates went to Florida, so I'm kind of a Gator boy. But Florida State, I like Florida State. The Seminole is always the rivalry.
So, well, say if you like Florida, I assume you did not like Florida
State.
Yeah,
I do not like Florida State, but it was always the rivalry. So I'm excited to go to Florida State. I've been waiting on this game. Sorry. I've never been to Florida State. I've been one time to see my friend play, but that was it. So, never played.
So how excited is it? I'm sure you've probably seen it growing up, being on TV and all that and everything. So now you want to play in that environment. What are you looking forward to?
I know it's another game, another opportunity. I can't really have too big high hopes to just come in and do what I do every Saturday and take it as another opportunity. Is it Florida State at the end of the day? Like, you can't look at their record. You can't look at the losses they've taken because they got probably some of the best athletes in college football over there. So, you just got to take it as a regular game. Prepare as if you're going into an undefeated team that's on the roll right here. So, you just got to take it like you would every Saturday, honestly. Just don't overlook anybody, no matter who you're playing, good or bad. The D-line really had a field day Saturday. I think just their consistency, like being able to bull rush the quarterback, keeping them in the pocket. They didn't let them really scramble a lot. So I think just keeping them in the pocket and making the plays when they came. They didn't like try to do anybody else's job. They wasn't trying to fight and make a play. They just did their job. And when that opportunity came, they made the play. So I think that was probably the most impressive thing, watching it from the outside looking in.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's been a couple times. I was just sitting back there, like, I had my dude covered, and I was just looking back, and I was like, okay, yeah, he's down. Like, he's down. We don't got cover anymore. So it happened a couple times. I was looking around like, gosh, they going after this man right here. Yeah.
So you guys got to watch a film with a bunch of your high school players in Ohio, and Coach Collins said that he wanted to just kind of let you guys play loose and free and see how you once did that in high school. How did that kind of help you seeing yourself way back then? And the other guys seeing them kind of play loose and free and having fun?
I think more so like just seeing that you've already done this before. You've already played the game. You've been playing the game for years. There's no difference. There's no difference in the level of the game that you play, like high school coming up. Like, you've already done this. You've been doing this for a long time. So just go play. Go be you. Go be the person that got you here. And while you're here, just excel to be a better person. But I think seeing myself play, because I played quarterback, which is pretty funny. So just throwing it back to the times, I was like, I used to have the ball in my hands a lot. So I think that just brought back some good memories and good times in my head.
Do you think it relaxed you guys some in a good way? It's easier to play loose on the scene if you relax.
Right? Yeah. I mean, yeah, I don't think it's just you watching your old film can, like, relax you. But I think just seeing what everybody did back in there, like, back in the day, kind of just brought, like, laughter, like, good times, good joy, like, good conversation outside of just football. Well, it is football, but outside of Carolina football, you could talk about just past. A lot of people was shocked by that. They didn't know I played quarterback. But I think Bo Atkinson, they was just like, you're so tiny, bro. Like, what happened? Like, you was tiny. He was like, that's my ninth grade film. I was way different. He was just like, what? Like, why'd y'all say that? I say that was probably the best one, though. Yeah. You know, I had my very first play. I had a good little run, probably like 50 yards. I should have scored, but I failed. I got tripped up. It was a great turf monster. I mean, it wasn't turf. I like spin and try to catch myself, and I couldn't. But yeah, that's not my best play, but one of the best plays. But if you go look at it, you should go look at it. I'm pretty solid. I could throw that rock a little bit. Okay. Yeah.
What was your best play?
My all-time favorite best play, I threw like a game-winner touchdown to beat Callaway. That's like our rivalry down there, and it was like the region championship. Basically, we had like, it's a long story, but we came back all the way down from like, it was like a touchdown or two, but then we had the ball to like score with like 5 seconds maybe, and we was on like the 40-yard line. I threw one of my teammates a fade ball, and it just fell in his hand, called game winner. That was probably my most memorable like high school moment.
They carried you off the field.
Yeah, they basically did. It was a good night. It was a good night. It feels really good. It feels good to get back in the winning column, you know, just because we've been working so hard and things just haven't been going our way lately. So, I mean, it feels good to finally have some success behind everything that we put behind the scenes. But just going forward, I think we need to just continue to just do as we do, like, don't change anything, win, lose, or draw. Like, just come to work, put the time in, watch film, practice hard. I think the results will take care of itself. Yeah, kind of like what you're saying, like putting it behind us, putting the win behind us, putting the losses behind us, and focusing on our next mission that we have to go play. So, I mean, just continue to practice, you know, try to be perfect. You can't be perfect, but be better than what you was. Work on something, like critique your craft, critique what you messed up on in the game. And I mean, just kind of practice, work on that, and then hopefully – if you work hard enough, your results will pay off for you. So, I mean, just coming back to work, you got to go back another day in the office. You got to get started. You got to get going. You said that one.
what parts of Saturday's game can you best carry over the rest of the game?
Speak on defensive-wise, I think we could continue to run to the ball. We had a whole bunch of hats around the ball Saturday. Like, one man may have missed a tackle or something, but there was five other dudes around him to make the tackle. So just flying around, not thinking too much, not making it complicated, not trying to, do something out of ordinary, just coming in and doing your job. Like, you handle your little 2x2, everybody handle their little 2x2, they square, and it fit the piece of the puzzle. So.
Has this team put the losses behind it, like you're talking about?
Yeah, I think we have, especially with that bye week. We kind of, some guys, whatever they did on the bye week, kind of mentally check out for a little minute, and then they come back and be like, all right, we got the rest of the season to go, 5 games left, so you just come in and go to work. So I think we have put it behind us.
You guys good? All right, off to the meeting, Susie.
Appreciate y'all.